I'm in my car, I'm driving far, drive time.
It's drive time, and I'm your host, Vernon Howell. Episode 10B. Let's get past these trucks. We just zoomed through truck alley. We call that back. 10B is a special episode. Let me tell you why. Because it is the first season 3 long form episode. How long? I don't know. I'm not sure. We'll have to wait and see. I only can tell you that there's a lot of driving ahead of us. Another thing I don't know. Sorry, I got water with lemon. I'm really pimping here in the car. I got my suit on and I got a glass of water with a half a lemon in it. We're driving northward in New Jersey for at least 45 minutes. At least. Nah, maybe not at least. I would say, well, yeah, at least, yeah. Probably more like 50 to an hour. 50 minutes to 60 minutes. Now, I don't think that this camera's going to hold out for 60 minutes. So I have to be aware of the clock, and there is this small chance that none of this is going to get captured. So I have a couple choices here. I can be wary of the time on the Nano and at 15-minute intervals, which makes sense because that's how I would have to upload these to YouTube. I click it or tick it, and I click it off, and then I click it on again, so we start a new video. I cleaned it, so there's nothing on here. I think 8 gigabytes. Is it 8 or 16? I forget which one this is. We have a lot of gigabytes. Enough gigabytes to chew. I am... sure, yeah, okay. I'm just thinking about which way I'm going to go. I kind of have to drive out of my office again, and that left's kind of overly... It's 1:12 on a Friday, in the p.m. here, Eastern Standard Time, of course, in New Jersey. It's turned into a nice day. Honestly, on the cool side, still. It's got to be in the 70s. I would say it's right, like, mid-70s. So, neglecting work, should I talk about that? I don't know if I'm going to tell you that. One thing I did, I uploaded two of the to-do lists that I've made for myself. Now, that's a hard thing, because should I just do those Monday through Friday? Do I do those on the weekends, too? I mean, the weekends, sometimes, my whole day is... You know, I will work around a weekend if I'm home. Projects. You know, I'll work in projects. But it's usually nothing I plan out. Now, maybe I should continue to plan. That's what I'm thinking. I should continue to work that every day and try and do that my best. Because I think I get the most done. When I can look at something and be like, what now? Instead of spending an hour, 2 hours of just bullshit. That is when I'm at my best, as far as in terms of working creatively. So, I think that's what we're gonna do. And basically, I just uploaded the screen grab. I didn't do anything else to it, so they're very simple to capture and save, and then upload. You know, that doesn't take a lot of time. So I was like gonna do something cute and quaint. Like I was gonna add a, you know, my big thing now, and my experimental films is I've been using a lot of like cheesy MIDI file versions of like popular songs. So I was gonna maybe use like a pop song as the theme song as the background for that video screen cap of me checking off the to-do list at the end of the day, as I did last night at about 12:30. And I uploaded the last two nights of that. So that's, we started that project on 6/12. Today is the 14th day of June. So this will be the third day. Now, most of my day is tied up until I get back tonight, and if I have some, you know, depending on what time it is, you know, what I have to do there. So, I don't know if I have the wherewithal, capacity, energy, do a little more work. I did put some stuff down that you could do. So I even had that stuff down. I think that's the way to work. Just map out your day. It's not spontaneous. It's anti-spontaneous. It's anti-spontaneity. Spontaneity. Spontaneity, spontaneity. Is that a potato-potato thing, or is one right or wrong? The thing about potato-potato, no one says potato. That's just a joke, right? I guess I never thought about that. That's just a silly joke. Who says potato? Doesn't make any sense. No one says potato. Imagine every food you just there had two complete different ways, and they were like, instead of oregano, it'd be like oregano. Or like, instead of sandwich, it'd be like sandwich. You say sandwich, I say sandwich. I mean, you can do it with every food item. Potato, tomato, though. That's. You know what makes more sense is mozzarella and mozzarella. 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 I usually say mozzarella. I don't say mozzarella. I say mozzarella. I don't wanna sound like too much of a jerky guinea type. No offense. Please don't take that as offensive. That's just, I can say that, I'm dying. Mozzarella. Eggs and mozzarella, you know, some fresh roasted peppers and prosciutto. Nah. That's not how I say it. I say mozzarella. So I get a little bit of both. Get the real, what's it? The real. You get the guinea version mixed with the layman non-guinea. What's in, just dude, the regular person, mozzarella sticks. Can I have some mozzarella sticks? No, it's mozzarella. Not mozzarella, mozzarella. Mozzarella, don't say it like, you know, who's that girl, Giada? You know, Giada? Food Network star, Giada. She says, oh, we're 10 minutes already. Really? You know, it's not quite 10 minutes because I didn't start filming until about 2 minutes into the ride about, so it's really a little off. So I can really go to 17 on this clip. Giada is, she says, like, in the mortadella, she, like, gets this, she goes, you know, flips on the accent. I hate that. Spanish, a lot of Spanish or Spanish language, you know, dialects. They'll like all of a sudden just go crazy, and then they'll drop back into their like totally normal English voice. Like, there's got to be a better way to do that. You don't have to become a caricature of the language speaking population just because you're using one of their words in an otherwise English sentence. I wonder if that happens with English words. I don't speak another language, so that I would not, there's no way of really knowing this, but like, I wonder if like in Spain or in Mexico or in France, like someone could be saying a French or a Spanish sentence, and then they know, like, for like the word, like, I don't know, like the New York Yankees have like Atlanta, New York Yankees. I guess they do that, and it sounds, I guess there's no way not to sound like an idiot saying a word in their language. Maybe. Like Asian dialects, specifically, I think I've seen clips on there when they say like, "Oh, Fred," and they're like, "Atenta, Fred," but that's different. Those are so those don't have anything. There's so little in common, and phonetically. All right, exhausted this topic. Get a little meta here. One thing I've found difficult, it's the wrong word, annoying, I guess, is how I've been posting these on my blog, vernonhowell.com, and I post them and then I re-edit them with a different title that kind of like in brackets puts down the topics. So that forces me to then having to, after recorded it and uploaded it, to then listen again to get that, to get put those down accurately. And usually what I'll do is I'll just skip a minute, two in the head, and get, like, I don't try and go crazy, but it still ends up, it's still another couple minutes for each one of these things. And I just don't enjoy doing that. But I've started now, so it's like, so I go back and delete the 30. Do I go back and delete the titles of 30 to 40? That way I don't have to do it again and it looks consistent. I don't have to keep doing it. I kind of like the look of it with this long-ass blog post title with, like, the episode number and then the content of what is discussed. Like, for this part of it, in the brackets, it would be like, about what this is, about this, about these bracket titles, these bracketed content titles. 14 minutes on the clock. I'm gonna stop this at 16, that's just to be safe, I'm gonna stop it at 16. I think we can cut out a minute of the, no, maybe not, maybe I should be safe, since it's cut it at 15:30. So, I really can't get into anything with it. Way to make sure I don't lose the whole thing, because if I try and do one long file, I'm just nervous that I'll just don't have anything. God forbid. Wouldn't that be just the worst fucking thing in the world? Yeah. This is so, I mean, I realize it's dumb. I don't realize it. I'm just gonna quietly let the drive go for a little, 20 more seconds, and then so I'll stop talking now. You'll just be looking at the road. So far, the way I hooked up the camera looks like it's pretty straight ahead. It could be tilted a little further down to get more of the road, but I think you're getting some of the road. It's not horrible. It's not ideal. I still haven't fixed it yet. I should have fixed it before. My goal is to fix that before Tuesday, when I have an even longer drive to film. All right, that's it for part one of episode 10D.